Hey, eco-warriors! Welcome back to Survival of the Greenest. Last time we turned trash into treasure, but today it seems awfully quiet on the island.
Finally, a break from all these challenges. What is it, Mia?
Wait, what's this? A message? The future depends on the steps we tread. Shrink your footprint and think ahead. Dude, why is everything a riddle?
Seriously, who comes up with this stuff? Shrink your footprint and think ahead. What does that even mean? Maybe it's talking about the impact we have, kind of like leaving a trail wherever we go.
What about those carbon footprints we keep hearing about?
Ooh, nice thinking. That tracks with Survival of the Greenest.
So I need to reduce my carbon footprint. But what is it? Well, footprints leave marks wherever you go, so maybe a carbon footprint is something similar? What do you think? Help me brainstorm in your notes. If you think about it, whenever we use energy, like driving around or charging our phones, we're probably leaving some kind of mark, right? Maybe that's what this footprint is. An invisible trail of carbon from everything we do. Exactly. It's the total amount of greenhouse gases, like carbon dioxide, that get released into the atmosphere because of our actions. The more resources we use and the more energy we consume, the bigger our carbon footprint gets.
But why does it matter so much? What happens if it keeps getting bigger?
Well, if everyone leaves a big carbon footprint, it means more greenhouse gases will be released into the atmosphere. That leads to heat being trapped, something called the greenhouse effect. Just like how the glass walls of a greenhouse let light in and trap the heat, greenhouse gases trap heat in the atmosphere. The increased heat leads to climate change, which causes things like extreme weather, rising sea levels, and hotter temperatures. Kind of like what you're feeling on the island. So we've got to be conscious of how much of a carbon footprint we're leaving behind. What activities do you think contribute most to your own carbon footprint? Jot down your thoughts to help us figure out how to start shrinking it. In general, some of the biggest contributors are activities like driving a vehicle that uses gasoline, heating your home with fossil fuels, and using electricity generated from coal or gas. Even the products we buy can add to our footprint, especially if they've been shipped from far away. It looks like you've started to understand the impact of your choices.
This is a great start, but I'm sure there's more to do. Let's figure out how to shrink this carbon trail.
All right, now the real challenge begins. We have to come up with some ways to actually start shrinking our carbon footprints. There's energy, food, the stuff we own. Where do we even start? Let's think about these three categories: energy we use, the foods we eat, and the products we buy. What are some ways you could reduce your carbon footprint in each of these areas? Jot down your ideas. First up, energy. It's not just about how much energy we use, but also what kind of energy it is. Renewable energy sources like solar and wind are much cleaner because they come from natural processes that are constantly replenished, unlike fossil fuels that can run out. But they're not always easy to switch to. That's why reducing the amount of energy we use is a good first step. Simple things like turning off lights when you leave a room, unplugging devices when they're not in use, or setting your thermostat a bit lower in the winter can make a difference. And if you can, consider looking into options for using renewable energy, like installing solar panels or choosing a green energy plan from your utility company. It'll save you money too. The choices we make about what we eat can also have a big impact on our carbon footprint. For example, producing meat typically requires more resources and generates more emissions than growing plants. So eating less meat could be one way to reduce our footprint. But it's also about where our food comes from. Locally grown food usually has a smaller carbon footprint because it doesn't have to travel as far to get to our plate. And don't forget about food waste. Planning our meals and using leftovers can cut down on the amount of food that gets thrown away, which in turn reduces the methane emissions from landfills. Finally, let's talk about the stuff we buy. Every product we purchase has a carbon footprint, which is determined by many factors, from the obtainment of the raw materials used to make it, to the energy consumed during manufacturing, to the transportation required to get it to us. One way to reduce our footprint is by buying less. Do we really need that new gadget, or could we get the one we already have repaired? And when we do buy something, we can try to choose products that are made to last, so we're not replacing them as often. Or we can consider buying used items. We can also look for products and packaging that are made from recycled materials or that are certified as environmentally friendly. Each choice we make, whether on energy, food, or the products we buy, can add to or reduce our carbon footprint.
When we start thinking intentionally, we can really begin to make a difference.
You know, it feels like there's one last step we need to take. What do you think it could be? It might have something to do with being intentional about the choices we make every day, like buying eco-friendly products or supporting sustainable companies. How do you think these choices could influence the world? They could encourage more businesses to go green, demonstrating consumer demand for sustainable products. Choosing products from eco-friendly companies sends a powerful message. It's like a silent vote for a greener planet.
Wait, how does a silent vote work?
First, we can vote with our wallets by choosing sustainable options. What everyday items could you switch out with more eco-friendly versions? How can you support businesses that align with your values? Pause to plan your actions. Maybe you could start by switching to eco-friendly laundry detergent, choosing bamboo products like toothbrushes or paper goods instead of plastic, or using rechargeable batteries instead of single-use ones. Every small choice adds up.
And it's not just about what we buy, right? There's also the power of our voices.
By writing to local representatives or starting petitions, we can advocate for environmental causes like reducing plastic waste. This collective voice can lead to laws and practices that support sustainability. Each of us has the power to affect positive change, whether through our own personal actions or as a collective team. What's one positive action you feel ready to take that could contribute to a more sustainable future? Make a plan in your notes. I could start by rethinking my daily habits, like using less water or walking instead of driving whenever I can. And I'll support eco-friendly brands and work with my community to push for smarter environmental practices. It's clear that finding your voice and making thoughtful choices are significant ways to make a difference.
Hey, remember that riddle from earlier? Shrink your footprint and think ahead. It's not about being perfect, but every step we take to reduce our carbon footprint makes things a little better.
Sounds like you figured it out. Way to go. Sometimes the challenge isn't flashy, but conquering it can still make a big difference.
Until the next episode of Survival of the Greenest, I've got a sneaking suspicion we'll be getting into something truly plantastic.
There it is. I knew we couldn't get through the conclusion without another pun. Well, at least we're not recycling jokes. We'll catch you at our next adulting adventure.